What's going on, everybody? Tunnel Shark Games here. I'm Corey.
And I'm Matt.
And today we're doing a 2015 Planeswalker review for
Johnny Steadfast.
It's the White Weenie variant of a Johnny for the new 2015 set. He's pretty fantastic.
Yeah, just look at this picture. Hold on. I'm going to bring the picture up. I'm going to just show you him real fast. Just look at that. You know, actually he's in a sleeve, so, you know, probably better if I just put a picture up, but screw it. Look at that.
He is pretty nice looking.
You know.
Probably my favorite Planeswalker in the set.
Oh, yeah. But so, you know, Johnny's just an amazing Planeswalker in any set, basically.
Usually you pull in a Johnny, it's a pretty good day. Yeah. This one in particular, he doesn't give you 100 life, but that doesn't matter when you pop his ultimate anyway. So, in decks that he's really good in, he's great for White Weenie type decks,
yeah.
Aggro decks, and multicolor decks because he works fantastic with other Planeswalkers as well. He loves to get the ball rolling on everything, and usually with him, games are really short, and you get everything done as quick as possible.
One thing I'll say about him, though, his, you know, plus one ability is, to me, probably my favorite, because I'm a big Force Strike, Vigilance, and Lifelink kind of person. You know, when I did play Mono White, I loved the most about it. His plus one is, you know, to the end of turn, up to one target creature gets plus one, you know, plus one, and gains Force Strike, Vigilance, and Lifelink. You know, just, I love all that kind of stuff. You know, then it's minus two, put a plus one counter on each creature you control, and a loyalty counter on each other Planeswalker you control.
That is where his multicolored useness comes in. You can pretty much play him with any of the new Planeswalkers, any of the Planeswalkers that are standard legal. Hell, you can play him in decks that aren't even standard legal. Of course, we're big on standard legal and everything like that.
Yeah, that's what we mostly play as standard. We despise Commander, we both do.
Yeah, we've got a couple buddies that play Commander and everything like that. It's really not our thing. But it is a cool game type for sure.
It is. Now his minus seven has to be just, I don't know, I like his negative. His minus two more. But minus seven's good. You get a emblem with, if a source you would deal damage to, you or a Planeswalker you control, prevent all of it but one of that damage.
Pretty much, you're not dying.
Which is absolutely perfect. Don't get me wrong, but that negative two is horrible.
Great. Other Ajani gives you 100 life. This Ajani pretty much gives you infinite life.
Yeah.
You're taking one damage. Say they throw thousands of damage at you. You're only taking one of that. Pretty much anything that's attacking you is going to be shot down to a 1-1 unblockable creature at that point.
Yep.
Just take the damage and deal it back. Usually you're not going to pop his ultimate.
Yeah.
Due to the fact that he is more of an aggro planeswalker, you're going to be dropping 1-1 counters on your creatures, giving them plus one, lifelink, vigilance, first strike. You're going to be knocking creatures out while your creatures are still alive.
And that's why I kind of say the minus two is more my favorite, because with him, you're not going to get to the, you can get to the minus seven. You know, I'm pretty sure you can, but you're mostly going to be using the minus two to give all your creatures plus one counters. Or that minus one, and just keep putting on the same person. You know, say you have a big, like a kitty god out there.
Yeah.
You know, if you have his name, you call him Kitty God.
Yeah, he's the cat god. It is Brimaz, King of Oreskes.
You know, say you have a, you know, kitty army out, and yeah, one of your cats up there.
Yeah.
It was used that, and they already have lifelink and all that stuff.
You got your big army of creatures out there. Why not give them all a 1-1 counter?
Yeah.
Maybe you have another Planeswalker out there too. Why not give that one another loyalty counter just to beef it up faster? Either way you play him, he's great for any deck.
The thing is with Johnny's, I'm not a big fan of them. I'm not at all. But I do agree that they probably, in my opinion, one of the best Planeswalkers of all. Because every time a Johnny comes out, they always have wonderful abilities. You know, like the one that came out in Nyx.
He's a 5-drop, but you're getting counters on up to 3 creatures. You're gaining 100 life. You're looking at cards off the top of your library, getting anything you can. This one, you're getting plus ones, getting different abilities for creatures. You're getting plus one counters. loyalty counters. You're getting emblems that are giving you hardly any damage taken. Anyway, you roll with a Johnny right now, he's pretty much one of the best planeswalkers in the set. Yeah.
If you can get a hold of him, I highly, highly suggest it because he's wonderful. And I actually don't know the price of him right now, do you?
He's not too expensive. Pick him up probably about $8 to $10.
And I mean, you should do that now before he does skyrocket.
Yeah, of course, know. The new standard's pretty much just 2015. The Theros block, and we got Rise of the Khans, I think, or Khans of Takar, that's what it is.
It's right there.
Right there on this box. Yeah. All right. But there's not that. We got two more sets coming out. Then we got the next set for the yearly block that's coming out.
Yes.
By the time the next set comes out, I'm seeing him rising in price for sure. He's going to be plopped in all kinds of decks because aggro is the way to go at the beginning for sure.
It is. You want
to look and get as quick a win as possible. And the best way to do that is really either you're running a red deck that's going to be burning people out, or you're running a white deck that's going to be jumping people out, knocking them out with small creatures with huge attack damage.
Yep. And that's all we have to say about Johnny. You know, just his name though. Johnny Steadfast.
Yeah.
He sounds like a 50s gangster.
He's going to be a 50s mobster. Yeah. He's going to run all the decks for sure.
For real. Guys, we'll see you for next review, which will be next week. So come back and see it. See you guys next time.
Appreciate it.